to my channel. This is Harmeet from themunk.com, and in today's video we are going to learn how to create a website without knowing any coding skill. Friends, today I am going to use Elementor Page Builder, which is totally a free builder, and we are going to use WP Zeta theme, which is a filter based theme, and we will going to create a website using this. And friends, these theme and plugin both are totally free. You don't have to pay any amount for that. Also, in previous video we have learned how to install localhost server and WordPress in our PC. So if you have not watched that video or you are new to my channel, then you can click on the I button above, or you can go to the description part. I will provide you a link in that. Now, before starting this video, please subscribe to my channel and hit the bell icon so that you will get notification of my latest videos. So friends, today I am going to use Zeta theme, which is a builder based theme, to create our website just from the beginning. So let's move to our dashboard. We have dashboard installed, and now we have to install theme, which is a Zeta theme. For that you have to navigate to appearance tab and click on the themes link. Here you will get some default theme of WordPress, and you have to click on the add new theme button here to install Zeta theme. It will open an interface for you to install theme. Here you have to write Zeta in the search column, and it will give you result of Zeta theme. The very first result is our Zeta theme. We have to click on the install button, and it will install theme in our dashboard. After that, we are going to install Elementor Page Builder. Using it, we are going to create our website. So now you can see our Zeta theme is installed, and now I am going to activate this theme, and afterward we will install Elementor Page Builder. So you can see this is our theme section, and we have now another theme, which is the Zeta theme. Now let's move to the plugin tab here and click on the add new link. Here again we have to write Elementor and hit enter button. And you can see the very first result is the Elementor website builder. This is a page builder. Using it, we are going to create our website. So for that also we have to click on the install now button, and it will install this plugin in our dashboard. Now you can see our Elementor website builder is installed, and now I am going to activate this builder. You can see in our plugin section Elementor builder is activated. Now we have to navigate to the appearance tab and click on the Zeta options link here, so that we will import a demo which is packed with the Zeta theme to get a quick start of our website. After that I will explain you how to use Elementor page builder to create our page. So now we have to click on the install importer plugin, which will help us to import available demo of the theme. Now our importer plugin is activated, and we have to click on the see library button here to see all our available demos. So you can see these are the demos which comes with the Zeta theme. You can choose any one demo here to create your website. So as of now I am just going to use this Elite demo to make our website. So you have to click on the preview button if you want to check it, and after that we have to install some required plugins, because these plugins are helpful to create this type of website. So you can see this is a beautiful header area where you can add your image as a background, and above that you can show your gradient color, and also you can give a big heading and button for your website. Below that you can create a section which is known as service section. It totally depends on you. If you want to use this section, you can use. Otherwise you can create any other content here. Below that you can see who we are section is available here, where you can write the details of your company or your agency. Below that you can see this is the team section, where you can see at the left side we have details of our team, and at the right side we have images of our team. Below that we have client review section, some product area where you can add your product if you want to sell some products through your website. After that you can see this is the contact us area. So we are just going to install WooCommerce plugin and lead form builder plugin. Basically, WooCommerce plugin help us to create product and sell product with the help of our website, and lead form builder will allow you to create contact form or newsletter form just like this. So these are the required plugins with the theme. So you have to install these plugins. Now our plugins are activated successfully, and we have to click on the import this site button, and it will give you some notification. You have to read it and click on the OK button. Now our import is completed successfully, and we have to click on the done view website to check our website how it is looking. And you can now see our demo is installed properly, and these are the sections which we have discussed in the preview area, where you can see who we are section are available, our team section is available, client preview section, product section, and contact us area is available. Now I am going to explain you how you can use the Elementor page builder to manage these section or to add your new content, or I will also create a new section and explain you how to create sections in your homepage. So as you have already logged into your dashboard, you can see this is the link added with Elementor. You have to click on this link and it will open an editor area where we can manage the homepage of our website. This same process will work for all the pages of your website. You have to just create a new page from your WordPress dashboard, and you can use Elementor page builder to create pages. So this is the editor area of Elementor page builder. Here you can see some modules are available which we can use to add in our website, and below that some pro modules are also available. You can get it by purchasing the pro version. But before that, I will suggest you that you can create your website by using just free modules of the Elementor page builder, and they are sufficient to create a very basic website. Or you can see, say, more than basic website is also created using this. So let's move to the section where we have text editor area. Here you can see this is the text editor area, and as soon as you click on this section, it will open that particular editor here. So you can see we have wrote agency that suits your needs here, and below that when you click on this button, then it will open settings of that particular button. So you have to just click on a particular module and it will give you the area to edit that module. Now let's learn how to use this module. In this paragraph area, you can write the content which you want to show here. Below that you can manage the column and column caps. These are the settings which will work on that particular column. After that you can navigate to the style tab here to align your text according to your requirement, such as alignment is available here. You can manage the text color here. You can manage the typography by clicking on this editor link. You can manage the font family, font size, font weight, transform, style, decoration, etc. Also, you can add the text shadow from these options. Now let's move to the advanced tab. Here you will get option to add margin and padding to that particular module, and some CSS ID, CSS class area is given. If you know some coding related to CSS, then you can give class and ID, and you can use your own code to manage these module. Also some motion effects, background setting, border setting, mask setting, position setting are available with this builder. Now let's move to the button module. Here you can use this module to show or create a button at your website, and also you can link that button to any particular page. So you can see that the type is default here. You will also get info, success, warning and danger settings up here, and below that you can write your own text for that button. And here you will get option to add link to that particular button. So you have to just add your link here and it will work in your website. Also some alignment and styling options are also available. Similarly to the text editor, we have also available a style for that particular button, and also have advanced setting for this button. So you can create a very beautiful website using this. Also, we have seen these are the columns which are used to add text. Now, when you click on the outer area of this column, it will open a section where you can add background image and gradient color of that section. Suppose we have this section which has a white background. So I'm just going to click on this six buttons here, and you can see these are the edit section layout. Here you can add the background color, and also you can add image to this section. When you go to the style tab, it will give you option to add image. So from here you can add image. Also you can add the background type to add normal color, or you can give the gradient color option here. So as soon as you click on the gradient, you can see these are the default values which is added to this section. And if you want to add a video or a slideshow, then you can use these options also. So as of now, I'm just selecting this classic color option, and we have already selected white background for this. Also, you can use the background overlay option to give background overlay to your particular section, and some border, shape divider and typography options are also available. So in this way you can manage the section. Now I am going to explain you how you can create a new section with the help of Elementor module. So you have to just navigate to the bottom of the page, and here you can click on the plus button to add a section on your page. So as soon as I click on the plus button, it will give you option to use single column, two column, three column, and multiple options are available. You can use them to add in your website according to your requirement. Here I am just using a two column layout, and you can see we have got single column and second column here, and now we have to click on the plus button to add module in our section. So I am just going to use a text editor here. Just drag here and drop it in your column, and it will give you default text of the text editor, and you have to write your own content. Also, if you want to add another module in this particular column, then you have to click on this module button here, and below that you can choose any module to add in your column. So you can see I have just dragged this button module and leave it here, and you can see the button module is available and the settings related to that button are available in the left panel. So you can write text to that particular button, you can give link, and you can manage all these settings, and you can manage the button from here. Also you can click on the style button to manage the color of this button. Similarly, in the right column we can add some images, or you can add any content which you want. So here I am going to select an image module here, and when you leave it, it will open a editor of that image module, and here you can choose your image according to your requirement. So you have to just click on choose image, and it will offer you to add your file from your local PC, or you can go to your media library if you have already installed or downloaded any image. So here I am going to use this particular image and click on the insert media, and you can see our image is added here. The image is little bit bigger, so it is not looking very perfect. You can manage image size from here. Suppose if you want to add a medium image, then you can click here and it will manage it according to its aspect ratio. Now one more thing I would like to inform you, that you can see that our text is just above the section, and we have to move this text in the middle of the column. So we can use a module which is the spacer module. You can see here we can put this spacer module above that text editor module, and we can manage the spacing of this module with the help of this space option. You can just give value and it will increase the spacing above the text editor. Similarly, you can add a spacer module below the button to add the space in your column. Basically, the task of a spacer is to add a space above or below the module. Now similarly, you can create more section for your website and can create a beautiful website for you. In this whole process, we have not written any code and not used any single line of coding. You can manage it according to the modules available. Also, Elementor provides you option to manage the responsiveness of your website. So you have to navigate to the responsive mode here in the left bottom side and click on the button, and you can see this is our mobile view. You can see this mobile view is available here, and you can scroll up and down to check your page how it is looking in the mobile view. If you want to edit or you want to modify some settings, then you have to click on this, and these settings will be work according to the mobile view. You can see this mobile is highlighted because it will work in the mobile view. Similarly, when you click on the tablet view and when you click on this no more button, you can see now our tablet is available. It means that all the settings you will going to add here will show in your tablet view. And at the end, you can see this is the desktop view. Here you can change the settings according to the need. So in this video, I have explained you how you can use Elementor Page Builder to create your website. If you have any query or issue related to this, then you can comment me below. I will help you with that. Also, please do subscribe to my channel so that you will get notification of my latest videos. My friends, thanks for watching my video.